I'm working on the Allen Scythe.
It hasn't run in about a year.
I think there was some sticky stuff in the petrol tank before I put it away, or always. Let's see if the get the fuel back down to the carburettor. So I'm slacking off the fuel line. Yeah, there's some old shitty old black tar coming out there. So it's flowing that far, so that's not caked up, that's something. But it smells like varnish. The next bit is down here to the carby. It's got a banjo bolt on here, banjo end. It does seem to be flowing there as well. Just what's in the pipe. So maybe it's just at the carb end, it's got snots. So it was turned off, so it might just be a bit of sediment, it's not coming through. But I need to put new fuel in it anyway. And I guess if it's as simple as this to take it apart, I should really seal it up with a drop of something before I put it away. I don't want to just put petrol in it or just put oil in it, because then it'll never go. If it does go, someone will think it's not two stroke, and it's a whole different world of trouble. You seize up a nice old two stroke engine. So, fuck. It is flowing. Oh, it tastes like old antique engine. It's a flavour on the lips. So inside in this banjo, there's a tiny little screen. You can see inside there, there's loads of crud, so I guess this is going to need a proper clean up. Crud. So So we're gonna clean up this fuel pipe. So we could have some carb cleaner or something like that, but good old petrol spilled everywhere. It's the cheapest and best, I reckon. Good old petrol leaves you stinking afterwards. Banjo's the bit I really wanted to clean. And that looks to be, oh, there's a bit of crud in there. Let's get some kind of a pick on it. I'm gonna be right to use. I've got a brad all here. That muck probably didn't stop it running last time. You can see it just there in the tip. Just a bit of hardened dirt. So there was a lot of varnish in the petrol tank on this one, and it always comes up. So last time I turned it off and purged the fuel, but it must have dislodged some bits of stuff. So I'm going to take off the carburettor and see if I can fish out any more gunk carb hole. So the carb's just held on this one. Well, I guess it's not held on this way, but the slide is one of the things that will stop me taking it away. So if I pull that up, it doesn't really have a needle. It's completely blunt on this one. I don't know if you can see that there, but it's just completely blunt. So I'll leave that hanging in free air. I'll get this little clamp off with a flat bladed screwdriver. The clamp comes off, and then this should all just slide off. That's it, pretty straightforward. It's just a straight through carb. So just the same, this has been sat in a shed for just over a year. It's got a nice film of oil and dust on it, which I guess serves to protect it because it's near the coast. And I sprayed it all down with just regular oil before I left. Didn't want any of the mechanism getting seized up, even though the logic was that I didn't want to be doing any of this stuff. But I am. So there's a bit of dirt up there I'll just take off before I go inside. And petrol and a toothbrush really is one of the best cleaners for an engine. It's a Villiers carb, I can see it written just here. Because I'm putting petrol all over this, whenever I go to put it away again, I need to give it a good coating of oil because the petrol will clean everything off, and then you'll either get oxidization on the casting of the carburettor, which I guess is some kind of an aluminium alloy thing. That's your tickler there. But this petrol's clearing it all up lovely. Like, in use, this will be covered in grass in 10 minutes. So, this is more about just clearing it up before I go inside. And with the rag, just drying it off so they're not covered in petrol. And then I go in through the bottom.
I've done everything so far with a flat bladed screwdriver and adjustable spanner. But you can see how dirty that water's become already, or that water petrol has become. So it screws off the bottom. There's a seal on the bottom. A seal on the top. There's your float. There's a kind of a film of thick oil in the bottom. There's a little layer of cruddy sediment just around the bottom of that shaft. Let's get that off first. Oh, there's the float gone. And there's the float pivot. And the float needle is just underneath that. So I guess I should go in there as well if I can. Don't know if I want to, if I can just flush it through. I don't know that there's any dirt in here. I think it was just stopped coming down the fuel line. That's the tickler there. All the tickler does is pushes out a little alarm. Pushes the float down. Let's more fuel oil mix in. Nothing much to it. I'm just looking in there. I can see that that float needle is operating, so I don't know if I don't think I'm going to bother taking that bit apart because it's more trouble. So I'm just checking the mating faces. I'm just checking the mating faces of this gasket or O-ring seal there. It looks okay. Give this float a wipe. Float's marked with Villiers. It was inside on the shaft where there was that bit of dirt in the float bowl, so if we clear that off, pull the rag through it, and give it a spin. So let's put this back together. Okay. I don't think that float has an upside. So the last bit, there's the ring come off the bottom there. It looks okay. Give it a bit of a wipe. And a dry. On the inside of this bowl. Metal brush would be better on this one than a toothbrush. It is a steel bowl, but I've got to do with what I've got here. The last bit's this nut plug on the bottom. Let's see if we can get something in there. You can see on the end of the rag, there's a bit of dirt on that. I'm gonna get a small screwdriver and have a look into the bottom. Yeah, there's a bit of sedimenty shit coming up there. So if I had an airline up here, it would blow out all the carb with the airline, but I don't. So I've got to have a look and see if I can poke through or blow through with my mouth any of those pathways, which is not ideal, obviously. Blowing into petrol. I still see a bit more down there. You can see that it's loose. You never know with carburettors, if there's a bit of, if there's a bit of dirt in there, and then the vibration of the engine and the petrol, the clean petrol swilling around it, can make any bit loose, so it's better to have them completely spotless. It's not always possible. So that looks much better. Okay. I guess I gotta use my mouth. Yeah, there was definitely something in there because that blew it out. Now I can see, if you look down the pipe, you can just see that little flicker of light in the bottom. Not ideal, but peculiar now, it feels like that wants to come out. This little grub screw on the side, I'm guessing. Don't know if I've ever been in this far before on this one. Yeah, that grub screw seems to act in that little slot. This is better because it means I can get a better cleanup. There's no more parts in there. It says MHJ on it. So it looks clear. Just about see light bottom there. See it better from that side. Much prefer an airline to blowing into that by myself. Yeah, you can see light, so it's me just spitting out any fluff that's come out that way. So while I'm here and I have that out, better check this needle valve, the float needle, and that's it there. And again, it looks okay, it's well seated, it's not pointy anymore. That's okay as well. Let's give a last dry up to this. So you slide that aside, tuck in the needle, put that back. line this up from the top, if I recall, with that screw. So go back in like that. The slot for the screw. It's stuck now for some reason. That's it, just gently. And you eyeball up from inside. You can eyeball up the slot with the screw. I'm guessing just tighten up this screw should hold us in a bit. You never know with these if it's the correct screw. Yeah, it's still a bit loose, but that'll stop it twisting, the screw. And when the bowl goes back on the bottom, that'll hold it in position. So I've got my needle in, my float on, my gasket's in place, put my bowl on. Give it a bit of a twist, seat it, put my washer on the bottom. My nut on below that. The only thing I should have done before I did all this was I should have blown through fuel inlet. Which comes in here. And you can hear that noise on and off. That was me touching on the float needle, so it seems to work. Letting it in and stopping it. It's all positive. Let's nip this up. Not overly tight, of course, because it is an old engine and we don't want to damage it. Villiers, clean frequently, wash in petrol, then dip in oil. What do you think? Let's take that off. So there's the Venturi. You can see it, quite a reduction. I can see in through the light of that gauze. That looks clear enough. I'm only going to be using it for a day, so I don't really want to clean that. Right here and right now. Just give it a wipe out for any dust inside. Get it back together. The last thing I'll check is that banjo screw. And the gauze. You can see that hardened varnish colour on it there. Not great. It's an aluminium screw, this. You gotta be careful not to over tighten it. I can see light when I look in there. So I'm hoping there's all the dust is shaken off and it's just varnish. There again is this little tiny gauze that goes around that banjo. And it's clean enough, I guess. I hope. So slip the washer on, fiber washer. Slip the tiny gauze on. And then the banjo and then the hose. So we've got this back on the machine. But before we put it back on the machine, I want to try and flush out some of this petrol tank a bit. It's got some kind of juice in it, which is pretty grim, I'm sure. Let's see if we can get the ends off. This tank, I think, came off an old Villiers lawnmower. It's not original to this machine. So there's one side. Sounds like there's something in there as well, like a nut or something that might have been used to clean it in the past and gotten stuck. So we'll have to investigate that. Yeah, sounds strange. See what comes out the bottom. Wow, look at that color of brown crud. I don't know if you can see that, it's changed my petrol completely. So it's clear and it's flowing. God knows what that is. God knows what's making that noise rattling around in there. Looks like the kind of bolt I've used to clean it out in the past. Probably couldn't get it out or it got stuck. So, normally I throw about 10 or 20 of those bolts in. Get a drop of fuel in here. See if we can rinse it out a bit. So, at least we know that when it is when it stops flowing out of the tap, there is a kind of a reservoir for sediment in there, that it doesn't completely drain the tank. So let's see what comes out. Pretty brown. It sounds like it's full of sediment as well, so I don't really know. I would like to have it going, some grass to cut. Plugs on the ends aren't drain-offs or anything, they're completely sealed, so it's very well made tank. Brass, it's got a tube running the whole length of it. Don't know if you'll be able to see. That bit of... sediment floating around the bottom there, flowing around to the bottom there. See, it's got this neck on the tank covered in green corrosion from the brass. The whole thing's a bit fucking rough, like, really. I don't think I'd be able to create a thingamajig to... really needs a second petrol tank for operational. But again, if I was at home, an airline might help to clear out the sediment. I have one more rinse. I don't use up all my petrol. See, the brown colour in the petrol is probably suspended sediments, so if I rewash it with the old petrol, it might help somewhat. And give it a final rinse with some clean petrol. With that for an idea. See, there's fucking loads of shit in there. Let's give it a shake. Put the lid on. Obviously, this time it should come out as brown as it was before. But it is flowing, that's the main thing. Yeah, that's flown out a lot clearer now. So I guess for this task, that will be good enough. Now the next question is, what fuel to oil should I mix up? I have a feeling it's 20 to 1. One. Let's get all this back together. So I guess before I put this away, I need to drain off the fuel oil, which seems to turn to varnish. Fill with petrol and leave a note on top saying, clear this tank before you start it again, Owen. So that I don't run it with just petrol and seize it up. Expecting rain today, but it's a Saturday. I didn't want to get out of bed. I wanted a bit of a lie-in. So I got a lie-in, which meant that the morning's been dry, but it's expecting rain, so it may rain. Then I mightn't get my job done at all. I really should use a spanner on that. Banner's better, it looks all lovely and clean. Fuel line, banjo. Fuel line, let's tie it on loose at this end. Loose, and then the banjo bolt. It's in, and the washer goes on. Fits? Does it fit? Maybe it's better to start at that end. Let's say it is indeed. Let's get this on a bit loose. If it doesn't want at all. We're in the thread now. And this goes on underneath. Not convinced I've made it that upright. Should cause up there. That's not right. It's always better with your fingers to check something's going on. If it's not going on right with your fingers, you just put a spanner on it, you're just going to pull it all together. These are only a fine thread, brass on brass. Do a lot more damage tightening it up. So the last bit is this slide, which looks well oiled. Solid brass by the feel of things. It has a little tab in there that lines up with the top of the carburettor. It only goes on one way and then that screws down. So I still have to tighten up that banjo bolt. Finger tight like that, and this one almost nipped up. So, the only other thing that could be stopping this going now, even though we know that that was probably it, is if there's no spark. And if there's no spark, it's a whole other world of headache. It's likely to be corroded points, given that it's kept in a damp atmosphere where it's stored. But, okay, that's tight. Check those nuts on the tank, they're tight. Let's take out the plug and have a look at that. I don't want to waste putting fuel in it. It isn't going to go. There's a plug spanner. Completely covered in oil, which I suppose is okay. It means the inside of the engine is probably covered in oil. Dark carbon oil. So let's set that there. Get a bit of string, a bit of a stick, something. There's no kill switch. There's a very faint spark there, which is good, I guess. Tiny spark, I don't know if we can see that. So, if all goes to plan, it's a small spark, but it might do. I'm gonna mix up some fuel and put it all back together. Small spark's better than no spark, so it'll either go or it won't. Let's tighten that up. Set the choke on it. Choke's down. Choke's just this slide here. So it opens and shuts that. So some fuel. Back to the bench. I'm gonna leave that fuel to settle out for a while. I've got a mixing bottle that gives me 25 to 1. So if I fill it to here with petrol and the last bit with oil, that gives me 25 to 1. This came with a chainsaw or something, not one that I bought. So I guess if that's 25 to 1, 16 to 1 should be a little bit more than that. So we'll put in less petrol and more oil. And let's make a funnel out of a plastic bottle. That out. We don't want any petrol going in here. Should I say, we don't want any water going in here. No, that's better. So I'd say a little bit more, a tiny drop more, and then some of this two stroke, which is not right at all for this thing. This is far too fancy an oil. This should have old heavy duty mineral oil, but we don't have that handy, and two stroke is two stroke. It's probably too good for it. It's really too thin and all this kind of stuff. You should probably just have old, heavy mineral oil. Just put that lid back on. Did a few turns. That's been sitting on the shelf for the last year as well. A few turns. Last time I used this, it started so easily after a bit of a tidy up. It started so easily, remarkably easily. I'm hoping it'll be the same. Let's find out. Fuel on, then I'll tickle it. You should see fuel dripping out. You won't see it from there, but you can hear the float now, floating. I can see fuel dribbling out the top. Perfect. Solved one problem. Too long. Give me a good chance to start. So open up the throttle.